You're watching NewsHour Plus. I'm Hari Srinivasan. This is when we scour across the web to find the latest and greatest in science and technology. And today we are joined by Molly Wood, who is executive editor at Cnet. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
All right, the big news over the weekend, of course, the new iPad 3G, which just means an iPad, but with some wireless connectivity.
Yeah, exactly. And that's about what it appears to be. It looks exactly the same as the Wi-Fi equipped iPad. And the real difference, of course, is in the menu settings. When you dig into it, you find the options for 3G for configuring your network access. One thing that is cool about this is that you can actually configure and sign up for that 3G data plan on the device. You don't have to call Apple or go to an AT&T store. And it is month to month. There's no contract. So that's pretty useful too. Other than that, you know, it has airplane mode, just like an iPhone, and presumably the internet everywhere you go, as long as you have service.
That long as you have service is a pretty important part.
Yeah, that one's a little bit of a killer. You know, it's notoriously rough in places like the Bay Area, which obviously is a pretty popular destination for iPad purchases. So we'll see how frustrated people are looking on the street.
In other tablet news, we've got HP that recently purchased Palm, but they also had their own plans for an iPad competitor, but not so much anymore.
Yeah, HP was working on a device called the Slate, which looked pretty promising. It was a tablet that was going to be running Windows 7. I think it was going to be a similar price point to the iPad, about $649 was the reported price, some pretty impressive specs. But then all of a sudden, right after they announced that they'd purchased Palm, HP killed off the Slate project. And it sounds like they're maybe going to go back to the drawing board. I know they're really interested in Palm's web OS. And so I wouldn't be surprised if they come out with a tablet that's running that operating system that really is sort of more like the iPad in terms of running a lighter weight OS.
And at the same time, Microsoft decides to hand over the keys to the kingdom to Apple, it looks like.
Yeah, Microsoft, you know, there were rumors floating around this web, the web of this Courier project, which was sort of a digital notebook, and it looked amazing. And then all of a sudden, late last week, Microsoft confirms it and kills it, kind of on the same day. And it really did feel like all of the tablet projects were just scrambling to get out of Apple's way. Hopefully it means they're going to go back and regroup and try to come out with some really serious competition, because I'd hate to get just a winner by forfeit.
Right. And in non-tablet news, kind of an interesting thing that I saw on your Crave blog a while ago, a diet coach heading in, sort of leading us into the era of the Jetsons.
Yeah, exactly. You know, there are all these robotic assistants coming out. There's this idea that, you know, there's obviously the robotic vacuum cleaners and robots that do your dishes. This one is called Autumn. It's about $400, and the idea is that it will act as a robotic diet coach for you, which some people might find a little more encouraging than a real person who might be judging them. The robot kind of, you feed it what you have, so to speak, eaten over the course of the day. It calculates calories, and it looks really cute, but it sounds like it can be kind of mean to you.
All right, Molly Wood, executive editor at Cnet. Thanks so much for your time today.
My pleasure.